Rain forecasted, but I might have to cook under my umbrella. I got that large umbrella on the patio. Really comes in handy unless it's a blowing rain from the side, so we'll see what happens. Got a new little project today. I know I've done ribs recently, but I'm gonna do ribs again today because I've got something that I want to test. And that little something is my new sauce. No, I'm not making it to market sell, but I'm just playing. I'm playing around. So this is I'm calling it a cherry sweet and spicy. There's been, you know, we use sauces that we like a lot sometimes. So I had one in particular that I was going to try to copy, not to sell, but just for my own use. But I couldn't quite get it perfected. I'm still going to work on it, but you know, a project like that, you make some and try it, taste it, and you add and can't take away, but you can keep adding different things to kind of balance out, and before you know it, your one bottle goes to four bottles, and then when you kind of add more stuff, four bottles goes to eight bottles. Well, I've ended up with a dozen bottles of sauce, but I'm still testing and still adjusting. But I wanted to try this, what I've got so far. And back at a certain place when I knew I couldn't hit on that other sauce, from some of the spices and flavors I was adding, I decided to take a right turn and just try to make one cherry flavor. And you know, everybody likes that cherry habanero that comes from different places, different sources, different makers. If I can get this really fine-tuned, I'll be giving some of it away in a future giveaway. Two small little racks of babyback ribs, and they are small. They're not but like 2.7, 2.8 pounds. And they came from the grocery store. I don't usually get my ribs there, but anyway, there's a store behind that. But I figured I would test my sauce out on these two small racks of ribs today. And over here is the JPAP all-purpose. I'll be going on with some of that, and I'll be using the Killer Hogs the barbecue rub. And then when we get ready to sauce them down, Pif'S cherry sweet and spicy. We'll see what happens with that. Stay tuned. We'll go outside to the smoke. We are outside.
I'm on the membrane. I already got them started. I just wanted to show you, in case you were new to doing this. You know, all of us are familiar with it, a lot of us, but you got to remember, there's new people coming on every day, young people inexperienced. They need to know. You put a knife up under between these ribs and get this up, this membrane, grab it with some paper towels and just hold it and pull with the other hand. There you go. And we're going to put some of this JPAP. I've been using it. It's really good. It's good coarse salt, pepper, garlic. Of course, everybody knows about Killer Hogs the barbecue rub. This is good stuff. Puts a pretty color on your rib.
Today we're going to use the Barrel House Cooker 14D. That's the small.
It's a real good rib.
Put some in like that. It doesn't take much. I'm just going to kind of dig a little hole.
About as easy as it comes, folks.
I like that part though, that you can take this little section.
Is a great feature.
you don't have to keep chasing this lid around. Where did I put it? You know,
apple wood I'm going to put down in the bottom.
I'm just going to drop them from the top since I forgot.
We'll let that temperature build up a little bit and settle down, catch up, settle the smoke. And we'll put those ribs on. I'm at sea level pretty much here at the coast, on the east coast in Florence, South Carolina. I've got my setting down on the bottom, that bottom vent on one. It's, you know, barely cracked, probably a quarter inch or something. And of course, top vents are these holes. No rods, just holes.
Okay, here's our ribs. They've been sitting with the rub on them. I sprayed them down one time with some apple cider vinegar just to put a little moisture in, help that rub cling. Getting ready to stick them on. Everything's cold, so I can grab these with my bare hand and stick them on in this big side. Let them hang right there. Let me know right quick, like I ain't cold. Your hook might be cold, but this bar is starting my timer. Not a whole lot of adjustment going on when you cook on a barrel. You know, any kind of drum, the way they're designed with the venting, you just put your meat on, make a real minor adjustment, and just let it go. And just wait. So that's what we're going to do. And we're probably looking about, I don't know, 4 hours. So now I get to go inside and sit in my recliner. Or go up on the porch and talk to Toby and have a cold drink.
Man, it's been an hour and 40 minutes.
We're running about 260. It's been running about 250 to 260. Got a couple of taters up there on the top shelf. Everything's running good.
Just wait. It's been on 3 hours and 17 minutes. They've been cooking it around 250 to 260. I have no idea what it looked like. Let's check.
I just want to see how they're going. I got those potatoes in there too, so I'm gonna have to lift them out for a minute. Real careful and gentle and no twists. Okay.
All right, this is after 3 hours and 18 minutes.
Trying to keep the gloves here off of them. And they gotta go some more. I just wanted to check them.
While we got them out, I may as well spritz them.
Doing this one time before and I had that tool and I twisted my wrist, and you can't do that when you've got a rib that's cooked. When you twist your wrist with that hook tool, you will twist it right in half. Believe me, I've done it.
Okay guys, it's 4 hours and 35 minutes. We're losing daylight, so I'm gonna sauce these ribs.
It's time to check out this Pif'S Cherry Sweet and Spicy. All right, about came out too strong with it. Going on real nice. Kind of in a hurry.
The ends of my ribs got a little bit crusty. The ones that were part that was close to the fire.
Well, we've seen that before, right? With these pit barrels. You can do that. That's all right. I know sometimes people will put the hook in the other end and turn them over
turn them around. Okay, I just put them back on. They were small ribs, remember, so I've got them stuck back in this 14D. They are up on the sides a little bit, but they are all right. We'll let them sit in there and in that sauce for about, I don't know, 15 minutes.
Well, they're done. They're ready to go. That turned into a 5-hour cook. I could have probably taken these up 30 minutes earlier, but I think we'll be all right. I might just do this and slide one rack of ribs over there on the board. Okay. I'm going to turn these over.
The angle of the iron's going in.
It's hard to tell.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes, even though they're upside down. Let's take this pretty one right here. Isn't that pretty?
Mm-hmm.
You see the color?
Yeah.
Do you know what that is?
Yeah.
What is that, Jeff?
That's Pif'S. Cherry sweet and spicy.
All right. We're going to try it out.
Yep.
We're going to see if it's got the sweet, and we're going to see if it's got the spicy. Let's go in. Mmm. Good bite. Mmm. I taste the sweet. That's a good rib. I think I need another bite. I might let Jeff do the little taste test on this. Take that one, Jeff.
Mmm, that's good. Really good. Mm-hmm.
Ain't much left. Not much left of that rib.
It's good.
Mmm. Boom.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
It's really good.
Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
That is good.
You did a good sauce.
It is amazing how different a sauce can taste dipping your finger in
it. Oh, yeah.
And then tasting it after it's been put on the rib, mm-hmm. a cooked rib, and then set. It tastes totally different.
It's really good.
I mean, it's great.
Mm-hmm.
Compared to others that I've had, that's a real good sauce. Well, now, I'm going to have to figure out what to do with this sauce. Which direction we're going and what I'm going to do. So, I'm putting the recipe out there on the drop down. And I guess you know why. So, I'm just, it may come, it may not. I don't know what I'm going to do with this sauce. But, so. With that said, I will be sending some out and on some giveaways in the future. So hopefully all that will turn out good. But I thank you for joining me tonight. And it was a 5-hour cook. And it was an easy one, though. The Barrel House cooker performed really nice. It settled down into about 250 and it stayed there the whole time, and me and Toby were just hanging out. So I appreciate you coming along. Hit that like button, leave a comment. And if you're not a subscriber, go ahead and subscribe. Hit the subscribe and the little bell. The little bell will let you know when I have a new video up. So thanks for watching. And until next time, this is Phil in Florence. And that's Florence, South Carolina.
And Janet in Florence.
That's exactly right. We'll see you.
Bye.